Hello students, welcome to this online course of hydraulic engineering. So in the previous lecture we have solved some problems based on like this your model analysis. So let us try to solve some more problems. So next problem is, it is stating a fluid flow phenomenon is to be studied in a model which is to be constructed by using Reynolds model law. So in the question itself it is stating that the model is Reynolds model. Now we have to find the expression for model to prototype ratios of velocity, discharge, pressure, work and power. That means we have to find out VR, QR, PR, WR and capital PR. So these ratios we have to find. So first is the basic equation of Reynolds is what? Rho. Rho r v r l r or d r to mu r is equal to 1, or this ratio is termed as what? Mu by rho is nu. So v r l r nu r is equal to 1. So we will be using this basic equation to find out various these ratios. So let us see how we are going to proceed. So in Reynolds law, R is rho VL by mu for model, and for prototype should be same if this model is following the this Reynolds law. That means rho R VR LR by mu R will be equal to 1, as I have told you already. So from here directly we can calculate this velocity is what. In this equation you can see like velocity is nothing but mu by rho into LR. So or mu by rho is what? Nu. That is kinematic viscosity. So directly you can find from here that V is nu by L. Now discharge is what? Area into velocity. So area is what? LR square, and velocity is already we have calculated. From here we can put the values here and we will get Q is nu and L. This is kinematic viscosity and this is length ratio. Now pressure is pressure ratio. For pressure ratio we have to find the force. Force is what? Pressure into pressure. Force by area is pressure. Force, we know that viscous force is rho L square V square by L square. L square is area. So finally we will be getting rho into V square, because L square will get cancelled out. And you will get rho square V square. V square already we have calculated. Just put the values here. You will get rho. This is nu. Nu. Not V. This is not V. This is nu. Rho nu L square by L square. So these questions are very, very simple. You have to just manipulate the data like according to whatever is desired in the question. Some analysis is required and you will get the final value. Now what is, how you are going to calculate work ratio? Work ratio means work is what? Force into displacement. Force we have already calculated, and displacement is L. So force is nothing but rho R V square L square, and finally we will put the value here, rho V square into L cube, because one L is coming from here, one L was in force. Finally you will be getting this value, and after putting the value of V you will get this rho r nu r square and multiplied by L r square. L r only, not L r square. And power is what? Force into velocity. You know force and you know velocity. Just put the values directly and you will get these values. Just try to do it by your own, the things will be more clearer to you. Now let us move to the second problem. For Froude model law, find the ratios of velocity, discharge, force, work and power in terms of length ratio. So here the question is more or like same, but the law has been changed, like from Reynolds law to we have been told we have to calculate for Froude's law. And one more thing is there, we have to calculate all the ratios in terms of length ratio. Okay, so what is your Froude law? Froude law is V R L R is equal to 1. So directly you can say From here only we will get Vr is equal to root Lr. And by using this equation and this equation, we will be calculating different data, whatever is required to us. So let us see how we are going to do that. Now, as I have told you, Vr by Lr is 1, or Vr will be root of Lr. So velocity ratio is directly we will be getting under root Lr. Now discharge is what? Velocity into area. Area will be termed, can be expressed as Lr square, because dimension of L area is meter square. That means length into length. So V is what? Root Lr, and Lr will be same Lr square. So it will be Lr raised to power 5 by 2. Clear? Force is what? Rho R Lr Vr. If the fluid is same in model and prototype, then rho R will be 1. Okay? So if it is not stating, we can assume it and we can write it. This is Lr cube by assuming rho r is equal to 1. That means the density, which the fluid which has been used for model and prototype, is same. So if you can put rho r is equal to 1 in these equations, you will be getting the terms of Lr only. So force is what? Rho r into Lr cube. Work will be rho r into Lr power 4, because just multiply one more term of length here, we will be getting work. Power is just divide it by work by time, or simply you can get force into velocity. Force also we know, Vr velocity also we know. So from here you can get this value. So these problems are not that much tough. You have to just see whatever is asked in the question, and you have to take the basic formula from the law, and you have to do the calculations. Now let us see some numericals also. And one more thing, these data you can directly use, if you have remembered these data, for Reynolds law also, because we have not done anything, we have just taken the basic equation, directly we have calculated the values. So these can be directly used in your questions. Okay, so if in the exam you have remembered that velocity is root over Lr for Froude law, you can directly put the values. No need to derive if like problem is of lesser marks. Clear? So let us see the numerical. So it is saying a pipe of diameter 1.5 meter is required to transport an oil of relative density 0.9 and kinematic viscosity 0.03 stroke at a rate of 3 meter cube per second. If a 15 centimeter pipe with water at 20 degrees Celsius, so at 20 degrees Celsius the viscosity, kinematic viscosity, is given as 0.01 stroke, is used to model the above flow, find the velocity and discharge of the model. So this is your prototype and this will be your model. So you can see the diameter is 1.5 here and 15 centimeter. That means Lr is given as, Lr is nothing but 1 by 10. So this is the, from the data also you can anticipate that we are going to deal with Reynolds model law. Okay, rho r is also given directly, the 900 for your model fluid. No, this 100,000 by 900. So from the data itself you can get the various values. Now what we have to calculate? The velocity and discharge in the model. So let us see how we are going to do that. So first we have written all the parameters whichever is provided to us. So diameter of prototype 150 centimeter, diameter of model pipe is 15 centimeter, kinematic viscosity in prototype fluid is 0.03 strokes, in model fluid it is 0.01 strokes, and velocity of prototype is can be calculated because discharge is given and diameter is given. So Q is nothing but Q by AP, Q by A. So Q is 3 meter per cube per second, and area is, since the diameter is given, so pi by 4, 1.5 meter square. So it is coming out to be 1.6977 meter per second. Now from Reynolds law, you can see here like dp dm, that means l lp lm, nu is given, nu m is, everything is given except b m. Just put all the values in this equation and you will be getting the value of vp, so sorry vm, vm it is coming out to be 5.659 meters per second. And if vm is, we are having vm, so just multiply that it with area of model, because diameter has been given, so directly you will be getting 0.1 meter cube per second. Now if you remember from the, I have told like for this Reynolds law, vr was what, nu r by lr, okay, and vr is v vm by vp, so this is 10 by 3 3.33, directly vr we can calculate as 3.33, so this we calculated, and vm we can directly get, so you can see same value we are getting. And also qr was nu r into lr, nu r and lr we have been given 0.033 into 3 is discharge is given, so directly also we can have calculated this. So this is the problem, we have solved it. Now let us see what is the next question. Next question is, the pressure drop in a flow meter in which an oil flows at an upstream velocity of 0.9 meter per second is to be estimated by model studies. That is okay, a 1/6 scale model. If scale model is directly given to you, then we have to be taken as is a length scale ratio. If nothing is mentioned, then it is a length ratio. If it will be like especially mentioned as velocity ratio is this, then we have to take according to that. But if nothing is mentioned, if a scale model, that means it is a LR is given as 1/6. So LR is given as 1:6 model, that means 1/6. If the pressure drop in the model is 450 Pascal, what will be the prototype pressure drop? If prototype discharge is 200 liters second, what is modeling discharge? So pressure drop and discharge we have to calculate for. If for model prototype it is given and we have to calculate for model, so okay. And some more data has been provided here, so you can see prototype and model. So density is given and viscosity is given for both the fluids, so we know our basic equation of Reynolds law. First step is to write it down and try to find whatever, what are the data which is given to us. So here you can see rho r is given. Now lr is also given 1/6, so this is not provided, but you can directly calculate. See, for model 998 and for density for prototype is 900, so it is coming out to be 1.109. so this also we have calculated, lr is also given 1/6. So only unknown here you can see is vr, okay. So if you can calculate vr, then with the help of lr you can calculate directly what the discharge, okay. So let us see how we have solved it. So pressure ratio is nothing but rho r into vr square, and vr is mu by rho r into lr, because vr is not given to us, all the other parameters are given but vr was not given, so we have changed it to mu and in terms of mu r and l. So finally PR we have calculated, 3 × 10⁻³. So PR is what, PM by PP, that means pressure of model is to pressure of prototype, and pressure of prototype if you go through question it is provided at 450 Pascal, so it is coming out to be, sorry, model was 450, so we have to calculate for prototype, okay. So prototype it is, if you will get this final value, or 150 kPa. So corresponding to 450 Pascal in model, we are getting 150 kilopascal in our original prototype. Now discharge ratio also we can calculate. Discharge is what, vr into lr square. We are not given, lr is given, so vr we can directly use from here. So it is coming out to be this ratio, that is qr is coming out to be 1.445 into 10⁻³. So qr is nothing but qm by qp. QP is given, so QM we can calculate 0.29 289 liters per second. So in this manner, like, you can have many many problems, but I have tried to solve some basic problem. So for your practice, you can problem any number, but the basic concept should be clear to you. Number of problems are not important, but the concept is important. Okay, so let us try to solve, like, one step ahead. Up till now we were having like one single model which was controlling the flow, but let us see how we are going to deal with if we are having more than one law which is controlling the flow. So the question is, obtain an expression for the scale of model which has to satisfy both Froude's model law and Reynolds model law. So we have to obtain the scale of a model. Scale means, this is also very very easy question. So we have to find an LR for which Froude number is also, Froude law is also there and Reynolds number is also there. So here we know this is VR is nothing but under root LR, and here also rho R VR LR is by mu R is equal to 1. So from this two basic equation, we have to see how we are going to solve it. Okay, so what we can just put the value of VR from Froude law into Reynolds law, and whatever value for LR we are getting, that will be your answer. So Reynolds model law, you can check from here. So LR is coming out to be mu R by VR into rho R, and also from here it is VR is nothing but root over LR. So just put the value of VR from here, this also can have worked. So finally we are getting LR is equal to mu R by rho R raised to power 2 by 3, or this quantity is dynamic density viscosity upon density is nothing but kinematic viscosity. So this is nu R raised to power 2 by 3. So this is also very simple, but you have to see how we can proceed. The first step is important, else you can easily go ahead. Now let us see one more interesting problem. So if acceleration due to gravity, viscosity and surface tension are equally important in a model, show that for dynamic similarity in relationship between viscosity ratio, surface tension ratio and the model scale ratio is given by. So we have to basically consider all three models. So if gravity is there, then we are having our Froude model. Viscosity is there, that means we have to consider our Reynolds model. And for surface tension, I guess we are having Euler's or Weber, I think. So let us see how we are going to proceed. Final expression is given to us. We have to just see how all the parameters we can. We have to finally calculate the model scale ratio. Okay, so let us see. So Weber model we are having here. So Weber model, Reynolds model and Froude model. So from here you can calculate VR is equal to this, or just square both side. We are having VR square rho R into LR by sigma R square. So this is the final equation we are having. And this we already know from Reynolds law, and this is from Froude's law. So what we are going to do, we have seen like rho is here, we can eliminate rho from here. In our final expression we need only mu, L and sigma. Okay, so here you can see mu is there, LR is there, VR is there, rho R is there. So we need to have mu, LR and sigma is there. So first of all we will try to eliminate rho. Okay, so from these two equations we can put the value of, just see this equation, these both are equal to 1, that means they will be equal to each other also. So from here we can get VR into mu R upon sigma R is equal to 1, and VR we already know that it is root, VR is root LR from Froude law. So finally we can get this value. So this was also not that tough, but you have to like see what are the parameters we want in our final expression, and accordingly we have eliminated other parameters. So in this way, like, only one topic is left with for this chapter, that is distorted model and distorted scale ratio. So that we will be dealing in the next lecture, and in next lecture this chapter will be completed. So this is all for today. Thank you.